Hello students, today we are taking DNA, that is deoxyribonucleic acid, right? Today we will discuss about the structure of DNA, okay? So if we are talking about the DNA, you can say DNA is present in the nucleus of the cell, okay? In the form of chromosomes, and it is very long fiber, okay? So how that DNA condense in the small nucleus or so many base pairs are present inside the nucleus, right? So many nitrogenous bases. Now the question arises, what are the nitrogenous bases? These are the nitrogenous bases. A, T, G, C, okay, E, A, C, G. These are the nitrogenous bases, okay? Then whenever they pairing with each other, they are said to be base pairs, right? They are said to be base pairs. Now the question arises, what is the structure of the DNA or how the DNA is made up of? So DNA is made up of pentose sugar. In the DNA, it is present in the form of deoxyribose sugar. And in the RNA, it is present in the form of ribose sugar, right? So it is there is the presence of pentose sugar. This is the pentose sugar. You can see here, pentose sugar means 5 carbon sugar. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Clear to all? So this is the pentose sugar. Everywhere I have drawn the pentose sugar. If the 6 carbon are present, the hexose sugar, but there is a presence of pentose sugar. The phosphate group is present, right? And the nitrogenous base is also present. And phosphate group and nitrogenous bases, right? Nitrogenous bases are of two types, purines and pyrimidines. Purines and pyrimidines. Purines are adenine and guanine, A and G, okay? And pyrimidines are thymine and cytosine, T and C, right? In the DNA, the adenine, guanine, thymine and cytosine is present, but in the RNA, the thymine is replaced by the uracil. Clear? So nitrogenous bases are present. These are of two types, purines and pyrimidines. Purines, adenine and guanine, pyrimidines, thymine and cytosine. Purine always pair with the pyrimidine, right? So adenine always pair with the thymine. Thymine always pair with the adenine. Guanine always pair with the cytosine. And cytosine always pair with the guanine. Clear to all? Whenever the pentose sugar attached with the nitrogenous bases, these are attached by means of glycosidic bond. There should be the presence of some bonding in between the biomolecules. Whenever we are studying the biomolecules, this is the chapter of biochemistry actually. We will study a little bit chemistry along with the bio. Okay, so this bonding is known as glycosidic bond. I am writing here glycosidic bond. So how the pentose sugar attached with the nitrogenous base? By means of glycosidic bond. And the structure of or the bonding or the phenomenon is known as nucleosides. जैसे ये pentose sugar है यहाँ से और ये इसमें nitrogenous base के साथ bonding कर रहा है. ये पूरा जो structure है ये क्या कहलाता है? हमारा nucleosides. Nucleosides. क्या कहलाएगा? Nucleosides. DNA is made up of nucleosides and nucleotides. One thing is also there, phosphate group is attached to the sugar by means of phosphodiester bond. Phospho means phosphate, phosphodiester bond. And the structure of phosphate with the pentose sugar is known as nucleotides. Right, I'm repeating again. The nitrogenous base combined with the pentose sugar by means of glycosidic bond, and the structure is said to be nucleosides. Right, and the phosphate group attached to the pentose sugar by means of phosphodiester bond, and the structure is said to be nucleotides. Nucleotides and nucleosides together form the DNA, structure of DNA, the fiber of DNA, the chain of DNA, whatever you want to say, right? Adenine attached with the thymine by means of double hydrogen bonding, and guanine attached with the cytosine by means of triple hydrogen bonding, or adenine and thymine, or thymine and adenine attached to each other by means of double hydrogen bond, guanine and cytosine, or cytosine and guanine attached to each other by means of triple hydrogen bond. Clear? These two are the anti-parallel fragments of DNA. Okay? They are twisted right-handed. Okay? Now, how they are attached to each other, or how they are identical, how we can say the fiber of the DNA, the two fibers or the parallel fibers of the DNA are identical to each other? How? Because if we are having the one segment of DNA, children, we are having this segment of DNA, we can write the another segment, or we can write the base pairing sequence of the another fiber of the DNA. Therefore, it is known as the identical copy or the complementary copy of each other. If suppose this is the segment of the parent, so how can we write the segment of the baby or the offspring? On this fiber will act as the template fiber for the formation of DNA of the babies. इस फाइबर पे ही हमारी क्या होगी, नेक्स्ट फाइबर की, ये वाला फाइबर अलग हो जाता है जब रेप्लिकेशन होता है, ठीक है, दोनों फाइबर अलग अलग हो जाते हैं, उस पर कोडिंग होगी अलग और इस पर कोडिंग होगी अलग. तो इस पर जो कोडिंग होगी डीएनए के सेगमेंट की, वो कौन सी होगी, ये वाली, क्योंकि ये इसका कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री है. थायमिन के साथ एडिनिन बनेगा, एडिनिन के साथ थायमिन, साइटोसिन के साथ ग्वानिन, और ग्वानिन के साथ साइटोसिन. जब उस पर पेयरिंग होगी तो वो बिल्कुल ऐसी होगी, मीन्स एडिनिन के साथ थायमिन, थायमिन के साथ एडिनिन, ग्वानिन के साथ साइटोसिन, ठीक है. देयरफॉर दे आर आइडेंटिकल और कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री कॉपी टू ईच अदर, ठीक है. दे आर ट्विस्टेड राइट हैंडेड, राइट हैंडेड साइड पे ये दोनों फाइबर्स एक दूसरे से ट्विस्टेड होते हैं. यहाँ पे तो मैंने आपको पूरा जो स्ट्रक्चर है ये इसकी थोड़ी कॉम्प्लिकेटेड है, आपको प्रैक्टिस करनी पड़ेगी 3-4 बार, देन यू कैन ड्रॉ इट. ओके, सो दिस इज द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ डी एन ए. जो बेस है इसका बेटा 3.4 नैनोमीटर होता है, ठीक है, और इनके बीच बीच में भी आप देखिए जो ट्विस्टेड फाइबर है डी एन ए का, ऐसे करके हम देख सकते हैं. ये हमारा बॉक्सिमेट्रिक मॉडल में आएगा, बाद में हम पढ़ेंगे इसको. तो ये वाला जो हमारी पेयरिंग है, इसमें 10 बेस पेयर्स रहते हैं, ऐसे 10 बेस पेयर्स हैं एक ट्विस्ट में, दूसरे ट्विस्ट में फिर 10 बेस पेयर्स, तीसरे ट्विस्ट में फिर 10 बेस पेयर्स. So the length of the DNA always depends on the number of base pairing present in the organism. किसी भी organism में, चाहे वो bacteria हो, चाहे वो bacteriophage हो, whether it is humans and also, ठीक है, तो base pair जितने भी होंगे उसी में depend करेगी DNA की length. और ये सब organism की अलग अलग होती है, सब organism का DNA अलग होता है due to the different base pairings. How the DNA of each and every person is different due to the arrangement of nitrogenous bases differently. ठीक है, सबके nitrogenous bases का जो sequence है वो कैसा होता है, different होता है. Therefore the sequence or the DNA are different from each other in each and every organism. Right? So DNA की nature कैसी होती है, acidic nature है. And two fibers are present, two identical complementary fibers are present, right? Purines and pyrimidines are present. Purine always pairs with the pyrimidines. Okay, purines always pairs with the pyrimidine. Adenine always pairs with the thymine along with the double hydrogen bonding, and guanine always pair with the cytosine by means of triple hydrogen bond. Clear to all? So this is all about the structure of DNA or the basic of DNA.